It is a beautiful, beautiful day in Cleveland, Ohio. That's right, Cleveland. Doesn't that roll off the tongue nicely? I am in front of a very, very special place. I'm standing on, well, I might as well be standing on Memory Lane. And I woke up this morning here in Cleveland, Ohio, and in doing so, I thought, what could I do to kill some time between now and the time I got to get on my flight back to Florida? And I thought, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to go to the Cleveland West Side Market. And this place has so many incredible memories for me. I grew up in a family of 10 in a city called Euclid, which is probably a good 20 to 30 minutes from where I'm standing right now. And every second week, I was usually the child out of the 10, more times than not, but not always. I was usually the child that would get into the car with mom and dad and come down here to the West Side Market. Mom would come down here and she would buy all of the meat. She'd buy the meat and she'd probably buy some of the fruit and what have you for the family of 10. And she used to buy in bulk. You know, they didn't have Costco's back then. So mom was a very, very smart shopper. She'd come down and she'd buy, I think it was like, 150 pounds of ground beef, you know, every 2 weeks, and something like 58 pounds of pork chops and what have you. And we'd go home and we'd get out the aluminum foil and we'd put it all into nice little packages and freeze it. But, bless her heart, my mom did an incredible job with the resources that she had in feeding us children. But anyway, so the West Side Market, we used to come down here every second Saturday. And my youngest recollections, I was probably 4 or 5 years old, and we had a little Rambler. The car was called a Rambler, and we used to come down in a Rambler. And then somewhere along the line, mom got dad to get her it was a Ford LTD. And it was a brown Ford LTD, I think with dark trim. And it had an 8-track player in it, if I'm not mistaken. And we used to come down and we'd listen to WHK, and I think it was Gary D or something like that on WHK. And if I'm not mistaken, I think the call letters were 1420 WHK. I could be mistaken. It's been, let's see, I was 6 and now I'm 32. So I was 20, that's 26 years ago. But anyway, when we would come down here, you know, I don't know what to expect. I haven't been down here since I was a little kid. And when I, you know, you can imagine a little 5-year-old kid walking through the market stalls and everything and just being in awe of everything. And one thing in particular I used to always be amazed of is they would have a stack like a pyramid of dead pigs, you know. And as a little 5-year-old kid, I used to sit there and look up at the stack and just like, wow, you know, that's really cool. But anyway, so I thought this morning I would come down and bring you along to for a tour of the West Side Market. You know, as often the case, I'm traveling around the world to places like Budapest and what have you. And I thought, you know what? Why not spend some time and do some videos of the city where I grew up in, Cleveland, Ohio. So as I do so, and I step in, there's a gentleman here, and he's asking people to fill the boot, I guess. He is a...
Despite muscular dystrophy, fill the boot.
He's a fireman, and he's asking people to fill the boot to fight muscular dystrophy.
Very much.
Happy so holiday. this is the scene that we would have seen going into the West Side Market. And I'm going to do as I normally do. I'm just kind of take you for a nice tour of the market. And unlike
good morning.
How are you doing?
Good. How are you doing?
May I have a sample?
Absolutely.
All right. Wonderful. Thank you so much.
That's the best I've had all summer long.
Oh, wonderful.
Hey, honey.
So, yeah, it's going to be interesting for me to walk through, because the last time I walked through here, I was probably 5 or 6 years old, and everything was a lot different back then, you know, and here I am now walking through the market, and I guess I walked into a gentleman's stall here. May I
The best all in the market.
The best all in the market.
Greg's Produce.
I went in through the, good, thank you. I went in through the outdoor, so to speak. And I've got to find my way back in. And what a contrast this is going to be to walking through the market in Budapest. So it really is something, you know. And here I can really understand the prices. Everything here would be in pounds and dollars as compared to being in forint and kilograms. But look at the beautiful produce that they have here. So Mom would come down here and she'd be shopping, and look at the beautiful produce.
Hi.
Potatoes, hi, grapes. Here you have your citrus. Really, really something. And I bet I'd be willing to bet that my friends Amadeo and Edit over in Genoa, Italy, are looking at this and really appreciating this as well. So Mom and Dad and I, we'd come along, and I think if I'm not mistaken, maybe we brought a wagon. We might have brought a wagon with us as we came through the West Side Market. And I remember as a child, if I'm not mistaken, and maybe it seemed to be a little bit more crowded as a child, or maybe I was just a little bit smaller and all these people here were just seemed like a bigger crowd than they were. But anyway, so this is the, I guess this is all the produce. And I remember, if I'm not mistaken, I think that we would hit this, section first. And I can't remember to what extent, as I take a bite of the cantaloupe, I cannot remember as to what extent Mom would shop for produce here. I think that the trip down to the West Side Market was more to pick up the meat. So with that in mind, I'm going to step inside to the main market hall, and let's go inside and see if we can't see some interesting things in there as well. And this is the view as you step into what I would assume is the main market here in Cleveland. And as I walk through, I'm going to share with you some of the history that I'm reading on Wikipedia. And it starts by saying the West Side Market is the oldest operating indoor-outdoor market space in Cleveland, Ohio. It's located at the corner of West 25th and Memory Lane, Lorraine Avenue, in the Ohio City neighborhood. And on December 18th, 1973, it was added to the National Register of Historic Places. So this is quite a historic place here. And continuing, it says the market began operating in 1840 across the street from its current location. Josiah Barber and Richard Lord, prominent businessmen and both former mayors of Ohio City before it was incorporated into Cleveland, donated the tract of land to Ohio City's government, stipulating that the land be used for an open-air market. The market space became a center of the Ohio City community for the following three decades, and other benefactors donated adjacent lands that allowed the marketplace to expand. In 1868, a one-story wooden frame building was erected on the site, and the newly christened Carroll Street Market was opened. Thanks to the brisk population growth in Cleveland and Ohio City in the latter part of the 19th century, the market outgrew its space yet again. And in 1902, lands were purchased across the street from the Pearl Market site to allow for market expansion. And it goes on to say a lot about this. Right here, I've come to a spot that says, culinary specialties, purveyors of fine European foods. So, you know, Cleveland has a large Hungarian population, and it wouldn't surprise me if they didn't have some Hungarian food in here as well. Matter of fact, there you have it. You can get some Hungarian hot paprika, or from Szeged, you can get some rub. So I might come back here and pick me up some of this good Hungarian specialties before getting on the plane and going back down to to Florida. But let's continue with the tour. So here you can see they've got the meats, and right about now my mother would probably say, give me 150 pounds of the ground beef and 60 pounds of the pork chops. And then she'd be looking at me and saying, Tom, go find your father. And there I would be. That was back in the day when you can let your child kind of go run through the crowd and go find his father. And oftentimes I would find my father, and he would be doing what he would always be doing, and that is talking to a stranger. And in doing so, he'd be pulling out the family picture and talking all about the little kids. And I'd run up and I'd tug on his jacket, and I'd say, Dad, I said, Mom wants you to come back. And there we'd go together through the crowd. Look at this place. It is really a really, really wonderful. I wonder if there's any old timers here maybe that were here back in the day when Mom and Dad and I would be coming down shopping. We've got some really nice baked goods here at that. I've yet to have breakfast, so somewhere along the trip here, I've got to find some place to grab a bite to eat. If I were in Budapest, I'd be looking for the poppy seed goods. But anyway,
I could have so much.
I'm just looking through the rest of the reed, but. It's better if I just walk and talk as I normally do here. So you've got all types of stalls here. You've got, this is easy to pronounce. This is Christopher's Bakery here. And then over here you've got Terzic's Meats. I'm not sure if that's, I don't know what nationality that is. And over here you've got your, we've got Riley's Bakery. So that would be Irish. So interestingly enough, the city of Cleveland is quite a conglomerate of different ethnicities, if you will. It is really wonderful to be back here at this market. And to think I was going to go sit in a Starbucks this morning and just kind of do my thing. Oh, now here we have, what is this? Naran spices and sauces here. We've got just a big collection of different spices that you can buy. You can buy poppy seed, rosemary, marjoram, mint.
Hello.
All in bulk, interestingly enough. And I gotta say, this past week I've been in Cleveland for the unfortunate and sad passing of my dad, Ernest Joseph Hall, who grew up here in Cleveland, as did my mother. And you know what? I gotta tell you that I've been tough on Cleveland over the years. But coming back here as I have this past week, it's kind of put a new perspective on this city. And it is it really is a wonderful city. What a contrast, though, to walking the markets in Europe, coming over here and seeing this market. Still haven't seen the big stack of pigs yet. Maybe they're outside somewhere. Here is Pierogi Palace. So this, I know pierogi. This would be Polish. And here you can come in and buy. Well, it looks like you can buy big bags of pierogies already to drop in the boiling water. There's Tony's Bologna. How interesting. Oh, and you know, this is an interesting sight here, to see these stuffed peppers. Whenever I'd be walking home from school, I could smell when Mom was making stuffed peppers up on the top of the street. And I would just go right past our house over to my friend Eric Walker's house because I hated stuffed peppers. And Mom would make stuffed peppers, and I'd go over to the Walker's house and see if I couldn't maybe have dinner with them, and hopefully they'd be having pizza for dinner. My mom was an exceptional cook. She used to cook for 10 children every night, and always did an incredible job. Here we are at a place called Crepes Deluxe. You know, when I'm doing a walkthrough video such as this, when you see a long line, it's usually indicative that you found something pretty good. So here we are at a place called Crepes Deluxe, and sure enough, as one would expect, that's what they're making. They're making deluxe crepes. There you see them making a nice, for her, I should say, making a nice strawberry crepe. So maybe that would be a good choice for something to put breakfast there. Definitely you can see there's quite a line going in here. Alright, here we go. Maggiore kielbasa.
That's right.
You want to put kivano? Maggiore ozag?
No, I'm magyar vagyok. Születtem, de beszélek magyarul.
In Hungary, I would say Tamás vagyok.
Okay.
Jó, and I just came from Budapest.
Great.
I was in Budapest for 2 months.
Wonderful.
And I did a video of the Great Market Hall. Have you been in Budapest?
Not for many years now.
Okay, but know the market hall there.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm doing a video of the West Side Market. I grew up here, and I used to come here as a little boy.
Fantastic.
And I travel the world, and I do videos, and I thought maybe I should share with the people where I came from.
There you go.
So there you go. And you're selling all types of stuff. You must have saged salami and...
Csabai and gulai kolbász and
fantastic.
Szalonnák, bacons,
fantastic.
Stuff like that.
Well, as they say in Budapest, köszönöm szépen.
Szívesen, máskor is. Viszontlátásra.
Thank you. Alright, so there you have it. I knew that I would see a Hungarian stall. How could you not see a Hungarian stall? So hope you've enjoyed this this tour of the West Side Market here in beautiful Cleveland, Ohio. I'm going to see if I can't go find maybe some other things to share, maybe on the outside of the market. All right, even though I didn't find the stacked pyramid of pigs somewhere outside, I was able to find this beautiful vantage point of the market here. And if you look up to the top, you can see it's got some really, really beautiful, beautiful brickwork all across the arches here in the market. And then if I pan down, it'll give you a really nice view of the market itself. Look at that. So there it is. There's my childhood memory right there. How wonderful to be able to come back, and not only to come back and to be able to walk through this market again, but to be able to come back and walk through it and share some of the memories of my childhood and recollection of coming here with my mom and dad on Saturday mornings here in Cleveland, Ohio. And then, oftentimes, as you will find, they have a place here where people are just kind of hanging out and enjoying their sandwiches and what have you.
Our youngest daughter was
all these people here are smiling. This young guy here was kind of waving to the camera a little bit earlier. Good morning. How are you, folks?
Doing well, yourself?
What are you having for...
Okay.
I'm looking for breakfast. And you folks are going to be on Tom TV.
Okay.
Okay. Is that okay? I'm doing a tour of the West Side Market. I grew up here as a little boy. And since leaving, I've traveled all around the world, and I've taken people to incredible places. But I came back here for my father's funeral, and I thought, you know, Cleveland is really a beautiful city in and by itself, and I thought, why not share it with them? And not only is Cleveland beautiful, but it's got some really wonderful people as well. You folks live here?
Yes.
Amherst, well, Cleveland area.
Yeah, suburbs.
So, well, thank you very, very much for taking a moment and coming on Tom TV. Yeah, so anyway, folks, there it is. And what a beautiful sight, and no more beautiful sight than what I'm looking at down there at the end, and that is the most beautiful sight in the world, the American flag. So have a great day. Hope you enjoyed this tour of the West Side Market in Cleveland, Ohio.